Today, I'm house hunting around the beautiful towns and villages of Southwest Cyprus. I'm Leah Charles King, and over the years, I've been involved in my family's property businesses, both in the UK and the Caribbean. Today, I'm going to be using all my skills to find the perfect place for house hunter Yuri and his daughter Cheyenne, and we have a property emergency.
It's like a hospital more than a house now.
And I think I might have to call a doctor.
Breathe, breathe, guys.
Wow.
I fancy a dip at this luxury villa.
Here we are, lower ground floor, this beautiful infinity pool.
Who doesn't love an infinity pool? But at the end of the day, do I find my house hunters their perfect place in the sun?
I think I might have a tear in my eye. This is crazy.
You both have tears in your eyes.
A little bit.
Yeah, it is.
A little bit.
Yuri first discovered Cyprus as a young man travelling. Now, over 40 years later, he and his wife Hazel want to swap Aberdeen for the Eastern Mediterranean and make a permanent move so they could enjoy the year-long sunshine. With Hazel busy working, Yuri has brought their daughter Cheyenne to help him with the search. Yuri, who's originally from Israel, has a budget of £180,000 to buy a permanent home for him and Hazel after living in many different parts of the world for his work.
I want to settle down, as we say. And that's it. I want to sit now in one place, which I know this is my place.
Standing in for Hazel is their younger daughter, Cheyenne, who's going to help her dad make the big decisions on our house hunt.
We've got a very close, instinct kind of a relationship.
Very good.
If he asks me what am I thinking, 9 times out of 10, I know what he's thinking.
To get to Southwest Cyprus, you can fly into Paphos in around 4.5 hours from the UK. And everywhere we're going to be looking at on this search is within 45 minutes drive of the airport. Cyprus has been settled since the Stone Age, but this part of the island is associated with the Romans. There are many archaeological sites containing remains of Roman tombs, villas and palaces, if history's your thing. Over the last 50 years, tourism has boomed in Southwest Cyprus, and it's a particularly popular area with Brits. In some towns and villages, the population is more British than Cypriot. Property prices on the west coast of Cyprus have risen by up to 10% in the last year because of increased sales to foreign buyers. But with property prices on average up to 20% cheaper here than on the east coast of the island, there are still deals to be found. Before we get started, I'm meeting up with my house hunters on the coast to find out what Yuri's looking for in terms of property and how Cheyenne is going to help him.
Well, Yuri, Cheyenne, welcome to Cyprus. How does it feel to be back here?
Very nice. Very, very nice.
Cheyenne, you're here to accompany Dad, right?
I am. I'm just here to help out.
Are you going to be supporting your dad through this?
Well, I'm just sort of here to be the voice of reason.
Does Dad tend to get a bit ahead of himself?
When it comes to houses, probably, yeah. Oh. He's a dreamer.
Ah, you're a dreamer. So you go with the heart, do you?
A dreamer, yeah.
So you have grandchildren in Israel, and Cyprus is very close to Israel, isn't it?
Very.
How quick on a flight to get
there? It's a maximum 30 minutes.
And Cheyenne, will you be moving out with your parents?
I won't be moving out, but you can expect me visiting very often.
So this is going to be a permanent move then?
Yes.
Yourself and Hazel want to retire here?
Yeah? This is the last house that we're buying.
So this is going to be your forever home?
Yes.
All right, so let's talk property then. What are you looking for?
Let's say what I don't like.
Okay.
I think it's easier.
Definitely.
I don't like the new houses, the new development. It's not for us at all. A garden, not too big, that I don't have to work too hard to keep it. Part of my dream is to have a little bit of chicken here and a dog and, not a farm. I'm not going to be a farmer now.
You sure?
With me, I don't know. Yeah, I'm quite sure. Swimming pool, it will be bonus.
Amazing. What do you want, like inland versus the coast? What do you like?
The dream is to be on the coast.
Okay, that's
the dream. But we have a budget.
Yeah.
And we are quite realistic. If it will be 20 minutes, 15 minutes, I don't know, from the coast.
So your budget then is £180,000?
Yep. There is a wiggle room. 200,000?
Oh, well, we could go up to 200,000.
Yeah.
That'd be fantastic. Feeling positive?
Very positive, yeah.
Good. Well, let's go and find you that house of your dreams.
Let's go.
This should be a cracking house hunt. Yuri seems realistic about what he can and can't get for his maximum budget of £200,000. And I reckon Cheyenne will help me keep him on the straight and narrow. We're heading inland to visit our first property, but before we go there, we're stopping off in the nearby village of Cyprus. Welcome to Cyprus Village.
Yeah, very nice.
It's absolutely beautiful.
It's got a lot going on for itself here in Cyprus, because not only do you have the tavernas that you can see here, it's also got a folks art museum, and it's got a boutique winery as well.
Okay.
Love that.
Yeah?
Yeah. It feels like one of those areas where, because it's warm and everyone's outside, everyone's chatting, you can always hear like a little conversation going around somewhere.
Yeah.
It's nice. It feels alive, lived in. And like you said, he hates the modern, so this is all exactly his kind of his aesthetic style.
A nice ancient village for you. Yeah,
exactly.
Well, you'll be pleased to know then, Yuri and Shai, that the first property I'm taking you to see is a 10-minute drive from here.
Nice. Good.
Happy with that?
Very, yeah.
Let's go and see it then. Property number one is just outside the hillside village of Palaemi, about 25 minutes drive from the coast and around half an hour from Paphos. It's got a very traditional Cypriot feel, but population-wise, it's split about half and half between locals and Brits. And importantly for Yuri, who's planning a permanent move, most people live here year-round rather than just in peak season. Yuri and Cheyenne, first property. Welcome to the bungalow. What do you think?
Very nice. You couldn't ask for more view-wise, let's be honest.
Is this part of the dream, Yuri?
Yes, absolutely.
This property is a two-bed, two bathrooms.
Okay.
They've both got en suites in there. It's very spacious inside. And it's also got gardens at the back as well, perfect for chickens. No pool here, but if you wanted to add one, you could.
You have a space.
Okay.
You have the space. So,
okay.
We happy about that?
Yeah. So now...
So far.
The price?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's on the market for just under £165,500.
No way.
Yeah, really?
Okay, so that's a surprise.
That's really surprising.
Okay, well, I'm glad you guys are impressed.
Yeah,
this is a good start. Let's get inside then.
Let's go.
This rural bungalow has loads of outside space, including a patio at the back, a covered dining area to one side, and a fruit and vegetable garden with its own shed. Inside, there's a large, light and bright open-plan living, dining and kitchen area. The main bedroom with an ensuite shower room and a second bedroom with its own patio and an ensuite shower room. There's also a separate utility room and a toilet.
Come on in. Open plan, living, dining, kitchen.
Wow. And that view.
Look! Yuri, would this be good enough for you and Hazel? Sat on the sofa, staring out at
like,
that view?
Like speechless, what did I say?
Literally speechless. Bless him. He can't say anything.
Wow. Yuri, you look like you've got a little tear in your eye.
Almost, yeah.
I think you do. I'm looking very good. I can see.
Very us. I don't know how to explain it, but it's very us.
There's obviously more space to have a look at, so...
Yeah, we would love to go
to see it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Come on then, let's go through this way. Go on in to what is currently being used as the main bedroom.
Perfect size.
Behind you is a wardrobe.
Loads of wardrobes, not just one.
Nice!
There's so much storage space.
So much storage space.
Wow. I like the floor.
I really like the floor.
I never dreamed to think about to put a black...
It is. It's
beautiful.
Interesting, isn't it? It's so elegant.
It's just beautiful. It is.
There is another bedroom with another ensuite as well. So look, go off, have a look, and I will meet you at the back in the gardens when you're ready.
Okay.
And I can't wait to hear what you think of everywhere else.
Okay.
Enjoy the tour. See ya. Wow. Who knew that the first property and they would fall in love straight away? I did not expect it at all. But you know what? I'm taking it.
What? Wow.
Nice. Spacious again.
Look at the bedroom here. It's even bigger than the other one. My God.
And bathroom. I like it. It's the same style as well. Nice. Big shower. How cute is this?
Wow.
Oh, can you smell that? That's gorgeous.
Wow.
Is this a lemon tree?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
What a beautiful place.
It's gorgeous.
I always like to make a good first impression, and this bungalow, which is on the market for just under £165,500, definitely did that. Yuri and Cheyenne seem to love pretty much everything about it, so I think I'm pretty much guaranteed a contender.
Well, I know it's a take your time, but you've been ages.
It was a lot to see. That was incredible.
I don't want to say it's exactly what I'm dreaming for. Yeah, it is, I must admit.
Yes. Really? Is it a contender?
This is a contender, yeah.
Yes!
I must admit, I'm quite surprised.
Wow.
So I thought that I will give you a hard time.
No, I'm really pleased that you're loving this one. So, moving forward then, what can I improve on? Because this sounds like you're loving it.
Now you give me hard time. So, 3 bedrooms. I would like to see the pool outside already instead of me to build it.
Possibility of a pool already there?
Yes.
Okay. Who knows what I could pull out the bag? Who knows? But if I've made you smile on this one, then...
I was going to say, like, expectations are high.
So if I cried on this one, what will happen the next one? Okay. I don't know. Surprise me.
Maybe I'll have to pick you up off the floor, Yuri.
Maybe.
Throw you on my back and bring you to the next property.
That's what you're going for. Floor him. He wants to be floored.
All right, then. Let's try it.
Okay.
Come on, then. Let's go.
Well, I couldn't be off to a better start, but I'm not going to rest on my laurels. I reckon there's still some room for improvement, and I think I can get an even better reaction from Yuri and Cheyenne. Before we visit property number 2, we're heading up into the hills to get an idea and a bird's eye view of what this part of the island looks like.
How are these for some views to spoil you?
Absolutely incredible.
Yeah, wow.
Beautiful up here.
We're only just about 3-minute drive from a little village called Fiti. I just thought it would be a nice place just for you to see the views, see the surrounding areas. Well, you ride a bike, don't you?
Yeah.
This has an amazing cycling route and a walking route. It's a panoramic view all the way, about 7 miles. Would you and Hazel do things like that?
I will do, definitely. If Hazel would do it with me or not, I don't know.
A bit of persuading. I definitely would. That sounds incredible.
Next property, couple of minutes drive.
Brilliant.
You could enjoy this all the time if you wanted.
Yeah.
Happy?
Very.
Come on, then. If it's more room for guests, that's important to Yuri. I can't wait to show him my next property, a 3-bed house with plenty of outdoor space. Today, I'm house hunting in the pretty villages and towns of southwest Cyprus, helping Yuri and daughter Cheyenne find the perfect forever home for Yuri and his wife Hazel. And so far, I've got one in the running. That one in the running is this bungalow, which my house hunter Yuri, who has a budget of £180,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room, really liked. The outside space was big enough to allow him his dream of raising chickens, but he and his daughter Cheyenne, who's standing in for her mum Hazel, would ideally have liked it to have more than 2 bedrooms. So 3 bedrooms is what I've got them for our second property in the town of Fiti, about half an hour's drive from the coast. It's a traditional Cypriot town, and the average price of a 3-bedroom property here is around £170,000. Though I've managed to find Yuri somewhere with loads of space for his potential feathered friends for a little bit less than that. So, welcome to property 2. I'm calling it the Lime House because it's got this kind of limey colour, but also there are fruit trees surrounding it as well.
No, it's nice.
Bungalow, just like you wanted.
Yeah.
I quite like the trees.
You've got 3 bedrooms in there.
3 bedrooms?
Yeah, 3 bedrooms.
So we have 1 tick without to see them yet.
Yes.
There you go.
Okay.
And just a bit more space generally around the property as well. It's on the market for just over £168,500.
Really?
No way!
Yeah. Good news?
Well...
The curb appeal is suddenly becoming a lot more appealing.
Good price, Yuri?
Very good one. Yeah. Very good.
Shall we get inside then?
Yes, please.
Let's go.
This bungalow has a wraparound Mediterranean garden, along with a spacious covered terrace for outdoor dining. The interior consists of a large, light-filled, open-plan living, dining and kitchen space. The main bedroom with an ensuite shower room, 2 more bedrooms, one of which is currently used as an office, and a family bathroom.
Come on in. kitchen, dining, living. It's all open plan.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Spacious. Very spacious. Yeah. In terms of the style and the taste...
This is very... which I don't like.
A bit more basic, in a way.
Query.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The other place, I could go in, put the stuff in the wardrobe and leave there. Here, I will have to work for it. But it's not a it's not a question of building and you know, heavy stuff, heavy...
It's not like you can't live
cosmetic,
with it for
a little
while.
Bit, no, really a little bit of cosmetic.
Exactly.
Not something major.
They can work on it over time.
What would Hazel think of the kitchen and all this space?
She would love the size of the kitchen.
The size, yeah. The size is excellent.
The size is beautiful.
Yeah. Colors, maybe she would not like it. But it's again, to change the color of the kitchen is very easy.
Yeah, it's not a project. Yeah.
All right, well, take a look at the rest of the space and I'll catch up with you.
Thank you.
Well, they don't seem to be blown away like in the first property, but I'm hoping that maybe once Yuri and Cheyenne have a look around the other bedrooms, they might just begin to fall in love with this place.
Wow, what a size, huh?
Yeah, very nice.
Wow.
And sweet, lovely. This is nice. Look at the amount of storage space you have. You're gonna have to buy a lot more clothes.
That I like.
Mm. It's another big room. It's gonna be my room. Cool. Okay. Food for thought.
Let's see.
Let's go, Celia.
Yeah.
This bungalow, which is on the market for just over £168,500, didn't massively impress Yuri and Cheyenne. But as it does give them all the space they're after, inside and out, I'm hopeful-ish that it could be another contender.
Hello again.
Hi.
Hi.
Now you've seen everywhere, but you haven't seen outside yet. So what do you think?
No. Wow.
It is
crazy.
Plenty
spacious.
Of room for my...
Cool chickens and a donkey.
And a camel.
And a camel.
We're really getting a farmyard now, aren't we? You notice, of course, it doesn't have a pool.
Forget about the pool now. To live here and to feel at home, it's a lot of changes. There is no character there whatsoever. Absolutely nothing. It's like a hospital more than a house now. Now, to have it as a house, it will cost money.
You're not feeling it, are
nothing,
you?
Nothing.
All right, let's waste no more time and let's move on to property 3, okay? Hopefully I can find you all that character that you're after.
Okay.
Brilliant.
Well, I've never had one of my properties compared to a hospital before, but despite that, I don't have any doubts I can cure Yuri's ills in terms of property at least. Before we visit our next place, we're heading out of the hills and down to the coast to have a nosy at one of my favourite stretches of sand in this part of the island.
Do you love a beach?
Yes, indeed.
Yep. We love the beach.
Oh, I love the beach as well. Well, welcome to Sandy Beach. And as beaches go, what do you think of this one?
It's beautiful.
Sand.
It's clean.
Plenty of place to lay about. Excellent place.
Definitely.
Yeah, there's loads of things to do on this beach. You know, at night they have sunsets with the DJs and the music playing. If you like, I know you like a bit of a boogie, Yuri.
A little bit.
So the next house I'm taking you to see is 20 minutes drive.
Okay.
Perfect.
So it still could be on your doorstep.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah, you're doing a happy dance.
I'm happy.
Let's do it together. And let's do it that way as we go and see the property.
Okay.
Coming up, if it's more charm and character that Yuri's after, I cannot wait to show him this beautiful 3-bedroom country house. Today I'm house hunting in southwest Cyprus, helping Yuri and his daughter Cheyenne find the perfect forever home for Yuri and his wife Hazel. And so far, we have a definite contender.
Yuri, who has a maximum budget of £200,000, and daughter Cheyenne really liked this bungalow in the countryside close to the town of Palaemi. But with 3 more properties to show them, I'm confident I can find them something they'll like just as much, or maybe even a little bit more. That could well be our next property in the village of Koili in the hills just outside Paphos. We're closer to the coast and the airport here than at any of our previous properties, which means it's the priciest area we've been to so far. And I've managed to get what I think is an absolute stunner without going too much into Yuri's wiggle room.
Yuri, you wanted character? I give you character.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
A lot of character, man.
Welcome to this old-style, traditional finca house.
Like something from the movies, honestly, it's gorgeous.
Brilliant. I tell you what, let's get inside and I'll tell you a bit more.
Brilliant.
Welcome. I'm squealing. That's how excited I am.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. Talk about speechless.
Well, yeah, the dream.
You'll be happy to know there are 3 bedrooms in here. Two bathrooms as well. And they're modern bathrooms.
I think I might have a tear in my eye. This is crazy.
You both have tears in your eyes.
Yeah, it is.
A little bit.
And it's currently on the market for just under £186,500.
Okay.
What do you think of that price? It is the highest we've seen so far, but...
It is.
Could it be worth it for this property?
So far, yes.
It's not my money, but I would say so.
So far.
Yeah, should we get inside then?
Yes.
Yeah, go on then, Yuri. You lead the way because I know you want to see it so badly.
This finca-style bungalow has a Mediterranean garden, a covered courtyard at the front, and this roof terrace with great views into the mountains. Inside, there's a rustic feeling, open plan, living, dining, and kitchen area. The main bedroom with an ensuite shower room, along with 2 more good-sized bedrooms, and a family shower room.
I think you're going to like this.
Oh, my God.
Your eyes are popping out your head. Your heart's palpitating, but you're okay?
I think so. Look
to breathe.
The handle.
Breathe, guys.
Wow.
Yuri, this kitchen has been handmade by the owner. Yeah. He handmade it himself with local wood. How cool is this?
Unbelievable.
So,
wow.
I've got to ask you, as you keep saying, wow, I'm asking.
Because
first
it's, it's just perfect. Oh, what I can say.
Perfect.
The way that the,
honestly,
these people have a taste.
They're geniuses.
Yeah,
geniuses. Look at that.
So this is your taste then?
It is, yeah.
So you could go off and take a look at the rest of the property.
I know.
and then... There's still a little surprise that I have waiting for you that I will meet you by upstairs afterwards.
I don't know if we'll survive it, but we'll definitely meet you upstairs.
Here to go.
Enjoy yourselves. Wow. So it sounds, or it looks like it's tears all round. Yuri is blown away. Cheyenne is almost speechless herself. And from what I'm seeing, this could really be the Cypriot dream that they've been after.
This is one room. This is the bathroom.
Ooh, very nice. Very nice. Look at that wall. Look at all that cupboards. Oh, my gosh, that's gorgeous. God, it's picture perfect, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, I couldn't have asked for a better reaction to this place, which is on the market for just under £186,500. I've no doubt it's going to be a contender, as Yuri and Cheyenne have loved everything about it so far, and they haven't even seen the roof terrace yet.
Come on up.
Oh, wow.
Isn't this lush?
Oh, my God.
Oh my God.
That's a surprise.
Listen, I told you a surprise.
That's a big surprise.
Wow. Wow, wow.
And of course, you've got this view.
That's amazing.
Still impressed? No, I didn't thought about that kind of thing with no land and.
Yeah.
And it is plenty of room. I mean,
so
it's
much no, room.
I can't say that it's small or. It is contender. No question.
Definite
about it.
Contender.
This is a contender.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
You were loving this. If
definitely.
I could throw a pool in there, how would you feel?
Knock him over
complete.
With a stick.
I think that would blow you away, wouldn't it? Come on then, let's see what I could do. On to the next.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, things are going pretty swimmingly. I've got two contenders out of three, and I think all I need to do is add a pool into the mix to make it three out of four. Before we visit our next property in the pretty village of Pano Herodes, we're stopping off in its main square so I can show Yuri some of the things he could potentially have on his doorstep.
Now, I know you love a quaint little village, don't you?
We definitely do. Yeah.
Well, welcome to Pano Herodes. What is it that you love about these traditional Cypriot villages?
It's very quiet and very calm, which is something that I need.
What I think you would love about here is the nice little cafe right here in the square, because they have a great Cypriot, British and Israeli community around here as well. Yeah.
Ah, fantastic.
Yeah, and I could just imagine you, Yuri, you know, talking about your chickens and your goats with the locals, you know, setting the world to rights, playing cards, doing all of that. That's part of your lifestyle, isn't it?
It is,
definitely.
Yeah. Thank you.
Well, look, next property I'm taking you both to see is not far from here, so this would be your village.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Too nice, yeah.
And there's something at this property that I haven't been able to present to you at any of the others so far.
What else you can show us that we didn't see?
This way, then, and I'll tell you when we get there.
OK.
Pano Herodes is about a 20-minute drive from the coast and is a very popular place with international buyers. The average price of a three-bed property here is around £190,000, and with demand outstripping supply, things can sell very quickly. So I'm really pleased to have found somewhere for Yuri within his maximum budget with a very important added extra.
Oh, wow!
Welcome, welcome to property four.
Huge.
It is. Now, I know you really like bungalows, but I couldn't resist showing you this one. I couldn't.
No, no, it's okay.
Is it okay?
Yeah.
Good. It is over two floors, but I think you'll like this because it does have that traditional feel to it.
Yes. Yep.
It's still got the modern appeal as well.
Yeah, yes.
What you're looking at is a three-bed, three-bath property. They're all en suites.
Ah, oh, nice!
Of course, though, this is the thing that I haven't been able to show you before, which is your own private pool.
That's definitely what I'm looking for when I come visiting.
And I can imagine you with Hazel and the extended family splashing about here, having a great time.
Yeah, I didn't want new development, but it's nice.
So this has surprised you, then?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Now, look, there is not a lot of land around the property, as you could see. Mm-hmm. Mm. Would that throw you off in terms of the chickens?
So in the end of the journey, like we say, we will have to compromise and to see what is more important.
It's on the market for just over £190,500.
Okay.
So it's at the top side of your budget now, mm-hmm. but still within that wiggle room. Okay. Put you off?
No, not
okay,
at all.
Good. good. Well, look, I'm not coming in with you on this.
Oh, okay.
Oh, really?
Okay.
Yeah, you're going by yourselves. Happy to do that?
Yeah.
Great. All right. Off you go.
Thank you.
Have a good
See
one.
You soon.
See ya. Oh, what a great first impression. Yuri and Cheyenne both love this. They love the pool. They could see the family here. And I think although it wasn't something that Yuri was quite expecting, it seems to be a thumbs up. And I'm here for it.
This villa has a courtyard around the pool, which includes a covered dining area and a barbecue, as well as two separate balconies on the upper floor. Inside, on the ground floor, there's a living room with a fireplace, which leads into a huge kitchen diner and a bedroom with access to the pool and an ensuite shower room. Upstairs, there's the main bedroom with a large balcony and ensuite bathroom, and another bedroom with a balcony and an ensuite shower room.
Nice. Very nice.
What a living room. What a living room. Look how many windows and lights. Wow.
Upstairs, ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Look at the kitchen.
Wow, what a kitchen. Huh?
It's massive. Ooh, very nice. And a balcony.
It's another wardrobe over there.
Yeah. It's an ensuite as well, don't forget.
It's high ceilings.
Wow!
This is a place for the morning, the coffee,
Absolutely.
And the sea in front of you. What else you can ask?
This villa, which is on the market for just over £190,500, is a bit different to everything else I've shown Yuri and Cheyenne so far. But judging by their reaction to its outside, that didn't seem to matter. Let's hope they still feel the same now they've had a good look around. Welcome back.
Hello.
Come on in, tell me everything.
Come back from dreams. It's a very nice place.
Yeah. What would Hazel say?
That's good questions.
Genuinely, I don't know, but I know she's going to love the idea of being able to swim in a pool every morning. She used to do that all the time.
Wow, so much to think about.
But for now, is this one a contender as well?
Yeah, yeah.
So we've got three contenders in the bag.
So far, yeah.
How on earth are you going to choose at this point?
I'm so glad it's not actually me making the choice right now.
Oh, I love you, baby.
Let's take our love and bring it to the next property.
Okay, good.
Yep, thank you.
Coming up, I aim to make Yuri and Cheyenne's decision even harder by showing them this house with great views and a lovely pool.
I have a feeling if you get this kind of place, so many of my friends are suddenly going to want to visit me on holiday.
Today, I'm helping Yuri and daughter Cheyenne find the perfect family forever home in beautiful Southwest Cyprus. And so far, we have three contenders. Those contenders are this rural bungalow, this rustic property, and this villa with a great pool area. But I've got a feeling my house hunters, who have a budget of £180,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room, will really fall for my fifth and final property, this house in the hills. But before we go there, I'm exploring the top end of the property market here in Southwest Cyprus. And once again, I'm up in the hills, about 20 minutes drive from Paphos. I've come to see this modern masterpiece, which is built to showcase its simply stunning views down to the Med, both from its stylish interior and its infinity pool and outside space. Of course, you don't get a vista like this for nothing. This place is on the market for £1.5 million, and I'm getting the tour from the man who designed it. Hi, Ernesto.
Hi, Leah. Welcome to the Callisto residence.
It looks terrific.
Let's go inside to have a look.
Yes, please. My goodness, this is super.
This is the upper floor. Also, in this level, we have the master bedroom.
And the way colors and the interior just seems to match everything.
Yes, here you have a spectacular view, as you can see. Also, we have the light coming from the other side, so it makes the space really, really amazing and very comfortable.
You've done a great job designing this. And you have mentioned some bedrooms.
Yes, we have here the master bedroom, which is amazing. I will show you.
Yes,
if
please.
You want. Let's go. So this is the main bedroom.
You've got the floor-to-ceiling windows, which just totally encapsulates that view, doesn't it? It's
yes.
Wonderful, makes great use of that as well. And it's got a nice little balcony out
yes.
there as well, so you can just watch the sunrise or the sunset.
Yes.
Another place that I like to sleep is by the pool. Do you have one of those here?
Yes, we can go downstairs and see what is going on there.
Yes, please.
Let's go.
This way then?
Yes.
Oh, I like this. You've done it again, haven't you, Ernesto?
Here we are, lower ground floor. We have another two bedrooms. We also have the courtyard. We have the living space inside and outside. And this beautiful infinity pool.
Who doesn't love an infinity pool? I could sit here, hang out all day, of course, use the pool, but I am on a house search. I've got two house hunters who want a piece of Cyprus, and I better get back and help them.
Okay.
Show
so
me
let's
out?
Go. Yes.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
That place might not be quite traditional enough for Yuri, but I reckon Cheyenne would like the pool. Well, who wouldn't? Before we visit our final property, which has got some pretty good views as well, we're making a quick detour down to the coast to bring back some memories for Yuri. Welcome to St. George's Harbour, which is very familiar to you, Yuri.
Very nice place, yeah. We used to sail with a yacht from Israel, sometimes with friends, sometimes as a counselor with kids. We used to come along the coast here, go into bays, you know, throw the anchors. The kids used to jump to the water, coming back to the boat. In the evening, marine, submarine near a town. They used to go to the town, sitting in a restaurant, going around.
Wow, and here you are back again.
Yeah.
And you could be living round here soon, couldn't you?
Oh, yes, I can live here.
Well, the last property I'm taking you to see is 25 minutes in the car.
All right.
So let's jump in and go do that.
All right.
Okay, okay.
Our final stop on this house hunt is in the hillside town of Strombi, whose population is around half and half British and Cypriot. It's a pretty popular place due to the fact it's around 25 minutes drive from Paphos, and properties here don't tend to hang around too long. I've had to go a bit over Yuri's maximum budget to get him somewhere I think he'll really love, but the agents told me there's a bit of flexibility here price-wise.
Welcome to the fifth and final property.
The fifth and final great house.
Yeah.
You get a pool.
Another gorgeous pool.
It's huge, isn't it?
It's great.
It's like a paradise.
You've got the outdoor space. You can have your chickens if you wanted to. You could even have a camel and a goat, as you mentioned, and a donkey. Throw them all in.
Yeah.
There's plenty of spaces for Hazel to sit and read a book and, you know, have a nice, relaxing time. And, of course, Cheyenne's got the pool. It's your thing, isn't it?
I have a feeling if you get this kind of place, so many of my friends are suddenly going to want to visit me on holiday.
You're looking at three bedrooms, again. Three bathrooms. Two of them are en suite.
Oh.
This is on the market for just over £211,000.
OK.
Now, that is over the budget. The owners have said that they'll be willing to accept offers at the top end of your budget. Well, let's see if it does tick all the other boxes.
Yeah.
And that you love it.
Yeah.
This yellow house has a lovely pool, a couple of covered outdoor living areas and a balcony on the upper floor with great views. Inside, there's an L-shaped open-plan living, dining and kitchen space, as well as a bedroom currently used as an office and a shower room downstairs. Upstairs, there are two more bedrooms, one with an ensuite shower room and another with an ensuite bathroom, both of which have access to the balcony.
Coming in. Open plan, living, kitchen, dining. It's all going on in here.
Wow.
That kitchen. Isn't that a gorgeous kitchen?
It's a gorgeous kitchen.
Yuri, is that too modern for you, though, in your style taste?
Yeah, it's modern, but it's a nice modern.
Would you live here yourself?
Yeah, where's the key? I would live here, yeah.
Where's the key, he says?
Where's the key, where's the suitcase, and let's go.
It's big, it's luxurious, it's comfortable, it's nice, it's warm.
So you want to see more then?
Definitely.
So you could take the marble staircase up to the bedrooms and go and have a little look.
Thank you.
Okay.
Do you know what? I wasn't too sure what Yuri and Shai would think of here because it is a lovely traditional property with some modern touches. But it seems so far so good. I think Yuri quite likes it.
Yeah, this is a bedroom.
That's
the size of bedroom.
Definitely.
Look at the balcony here. Look at the view. Wow,
I don't think we've had a view like that before.
You made it every morning, cup of coffee here. Heaven.
Once again, I seem to have delivered somewhere which Cheyenne and Yuri really love. This house is on the market for just over £211,000, which is over Yuri's maximum budget. But the agents told me there's some room for negotiation there. So I think I might well have found myself my fourth contender.
Hi, welcome back.
Hi.
How was it?
Beautiful house.
Luxury of it. I've never imagined them in a house this incredible.
Yeah, I never even dreamed that I would be in this kind of houses. Plenty of room, beautiful kitchen.
Beautiful kitchen.
It's a lot to think about, yeah, but there's no question it's contender.
Oh, wow, so there's four contenders at this point.
No, we have two.
And what are those two houses?
The first one is the Arodos house.
Oh, yes.
And the second line is the Yellow House.
Right. So the one we saw just before this, lovely house in Pana Arodos there, and then this gorgeous yellow house up here. Brilliant. Yeah. It's been a great search, but now it's over.
Over, yeah.
Until tomorrow.
We'll see you again.
Tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yep.
All right, let's go. To find out more information on any of the properties featured in today's show, go to aplaceinthesun.com/programs. We've shown Yuri and Cheyenne all five properties in Southwest Cyprus for their budget of £180,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room. And after a fantastic search, we've narrowed it down to two contenders. This villa in the village of Pana Erodis and this yellow house in the town of Strombi. Now they've had some time to think and no doubt talk things through with Yuri's wife Hazel back home. I can't wait to find out what they want to do. Okay, here we are, brand new day. A good night?
It's a good night.
It tells you how happy he is with his decision. He slept like a baby.
Yeah.
Oh.
Was it tossing and turning?
Yeah.
So you spoke to Hazel last night?
We did.
Went through all the houses, all the details. Yeah, I think we found the place. I think we will put offer.
On which property?
Number four, the
Erodis house. It's got everything that they need and it doesn't require any major constructural changes for them to just move in and live there. Erodis house just makes the most sense.
Ticks all the boxes?
Indeed.
Yeah.
So the Erodis property is on the market for just over £190,500.
I want to start with the 163.
Okay.
Starting offer.
So that's a starting offer. What's your thoughts behind the offer? You're just going to come low and see what they think?
Yeah, you know.
Testing the waters.
We're testing the waters, that's exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Let's give the agent a call. Hi, Tony, it's Leah calling. How are you? I'm very well. I've got some really good news for you, actually. So Yuri and Cheyenne, they absolutely love the house in Erodis. And they'd like to put in an offer with you. Yeah, so the offer they would like to put in is £163,000. Speak to you in a bit, Tony. Bye-bye.
So now we're waiting for him.
Now we wait for him to call us back. He said, you know, he didn't sound shocked, actually. He said, OK, look, let me call up the owners and speak with them and give you a call back.
OK, great.
So the strategy now, obviously, you've come in about 15% lower to the asking price, right?
Yeah, the maximum that I want to go up, it's 10%.
OK, wow, straight talking, you're
right. Yeah, I did all my calculation.
Ringing. Hello, Leah speaking. Hi, Tony, how are you? Yeah. Thanks a lot, bye. So look, he's spoken to the owners, they're in the UK. They're a bit like you, they're straight talking people. And they said that the offer you put in of 163 is too low for them. The lowest they're willing to go is 182,000.
They ask for 82.
182,000.
Right, 78.
So you were looking at the top end would be £178,000. Yeah. What about meeting in the middle?
Yeah, 180.
If they really want to sell, maybe they'd be willing for £2,000. Yeah, you're compromising.
Try it. Yeah, let's try it.
Yeah?
80, yeah?
Let's give that a whirl. Hi, Tony. So I've just been talking with Yuri and Cheyenne. Does love the property. If we can meet in the middle at £180,000, Yuri would be a very happy man, and so would Hazel, his wife, and his whole family. Thank you, Tony. Speak to you in a bit. He said, OK, let me go away. Let me speak to them. £2,000 in it at this point. You know, if you guys can meet in the... Well, there's £4,000 in total, but if you guys can meet in the middle,
yes.
That's £2,000 on either side. Oh, here we go. Hi, Tony. Okay, thanks, Tony. I'll pass on. Pleased to tell you both that they've accepted £180,000.
No!
You're kidding. Yes, they've done it. Yuri, you've done it. Hazel's done it. Cheyenne, well done. Look at you. Look, he's crying. Yuri, I'm loving this right now for you. Well done to Yuri, to Hazel, and to all the family. Cheyenne, well done for helping Dad. This
Thank
has
you.
Been great.
Thank
Yuri has been looking for his dream forever home for himself and his wife Hazel for the last year and a half. And finally, he's found it. And very soon, they'll be living here with all the family. I really wish them the best.
Your festive feast needn't be a long, drawn-out affair. Simplify whilst retaining all the essential trimmings. All new Jamie's Easy Christmas here tonight at 8. A gift crafted with all the festive charm without breaking the bank. Open up your imagination for this time of the year. All new Kirsty's Handmade Christmas is next.